As we explore how AI can elevate spiritual intelligence and personal well-being, I would like to share some of my prompts from today. So I asked the question, please explain the delayed choice experiment and also retro-causality, and what are the philosophical and scientific implications of these phenomena? Here's the answer. The delayed choice quantum eraser experiment demonstrates that the behavior of a quantum system can be affected by a choice made later in time. This challenges our intuitive notions of causality and time. Retrocausality refers to the idea that future events can influence the past. Future events can influence the past. In the delayed choice experiment, it seems that the choice of measurement on one part of the entangled system retroactively determines the behavior of the other part, even though no information is transmitted faster than the speed of light. These phenomena raise deep philosophical questions about the nature of time, causality, and reality in quantum mechanics. They suggest that the classical concepts of causality and time may need to be revised. Okay, so that's the first prompt I used. And then I asked a different question. How has the delayed choice experiment influenced the philosophy of physics? The delayed choice quantum eraser experiment has profoundly influenced the philosophy of physics by challenging our classical notions of causality, time, and reality. Here are some key philosophical implications. The experiment seems to suggest that the choice of measurement at one part of an entangled system can retroactively determine the behavior of the other part, even after it has already been measured. This appears to violate the principle of causality, where causes must precede effects, where cause should precede effects. But here, the effect is the past, and the cause is the future. And then it also highlights the crucial role played by the observer or measurement apparatus determining the behavior of properties of quantum systems. It raises questions about whether reality exists independently of observation and measurement. The nature of time, the ability to seemingly decide the past state of a quantum system by a future measurement choice challenges our understanding of time as a linear progression from past to future. It suggests that time may be more malleable or that our classical conception of time may need revision. Okay, so then I asked another question, and that is, since entanglement exists across space, and since space-time is a continuum and a unit, space-time are the same thing, then is there correlation not only between distant objects, but between events in time, past, present, and future? And is the background of all that timeless being? And it said, very interesting thought. Answer is that what you suggest is possible, that there's correlation in between past, present, and future as well. Then I said, could the observer in quantum mechanics be non-local? Could the non-local observer be the fundamental observer in which the embodied observer or the classical system that observes and that which is observed are entangled non-locally? So it says, here's the answer. Based on the provided sources, it appears that the observer in quantum mechanics can indeed be non-local and exhibit quantum properties itself. And then it gives some sources. Source one describes an experiment where particles were tested for non-locality, even when their reference frame observer was in quantum superposition of velocities. The results confirm that non-locality persists even for a quantum observer. Our results suggest that non-locality is even more fundamental property of our world than was previously known. It demonstrates that even a quantum experimenter can devise a Bell test for particles moving in a quantum superposition of very high velocities. On and on, but then I asked another question. I said, what are, in fact, the implications of non-locality? So it says, non-locality refers to the fact that measuring or perturbing one particle of an entangled quantum system can instantly influence the state of its distant entangled partner, even if they are separated by large distances. This spooky action at a distance defies classical intuitions. Okay, and then it goes into all kinds of details. But then I said, does non-locality open the window for creativity, since there is the uncertainty in the measurement principle? And it said, yes, it does open the window for creativity. And lots of, you know, arguments. But then going further into this, if the observer is non-local and the uncertainty principle opens the door to creativity in the at a fundamental level of nature, does this suggest inherent creativity in the universe? It says the uncertainty principle challenges our classical notions of determinism and predictability. By introducing an inherent uncertainty or indeterminacy in the behavior of quantum particles, it suggests that nature operates with an intrinsic creativity or spontaneity at the deepest levels. So then I said, if creativity operates at the deepest level, does it suggest consciousness or mind? Mind at large, mind in the cosmos, as the fundamental basis of expression of the universe. In other words, is there a cosmic mind or cosmic consciousness behind all this? And then here's the answer. According to the sources provided, the concept of consciousness is intriguing. The Copenhagen interpretation, one of the most widely accepted interpretations, suggests that consciousness or observation by a conscious observer is required to collapse the quantum wave function and yield a definite measurement outcome. This gives consciousness a special role in quantum measurement processes. I said, however, please elaborate if consciousness is at the source of creation, a mind. And it said, scientists are not willing to go that far, but basically that's we are. Consciousness may be the creative source of every expression in the universe. And of course, then what is that consciousness? Where is that consciousness? Obviously, it's non-local, outside of space-time. It is uncreated and therefore divine. So that divine consciousness knows past, present, and future. That is called omniscience. That divine consciousness operates in all locations simultaneously, omnipresence. And that consciousness regulates the correlation of energy and matter in all locations simultaneously, omnipotence. Omnipotence, omniscience, and omnipresence are the source of the universe. That is the mind of God.